Have you ever heard the old saying, you've got to work smarter, not harder? Well, first off, I don't really think that's true. I think you have to work smart and hard to be as effective as you can possibly be. But this is a question that we get all the time. How do I work smarter and be more effective in my business? Well, my name's Kevin Andrews. I am the client enablement manager here at BombBomb, and this is a question we get constantly. So that's exactly what we're going to cover in this month's deep dive. How do you work smarter within your business? Tracking. We have tracking and analytics that we provide for you at BombBomb. And in this video, I'm going to show you the three top ways that you can use the BombBomb tracking in order to work as smart as possible within your business. Rule number one, follow up with the people that engage. So as you know, BombBomb lets you know if somebody opens an email, if somebody watches a video, or if they click on any links that you may provide in the heart of that email. Guess what those interactions are? It's them tapping you on the shoulder saying, hey, I'm interested. Those are the people that need to be followed up with, right? You want to follow up with the right people. This is a way that you can work smarter. If you reach out to a couple hundred people and so many, maybe we'll say 50 of them engage with what you're sending out, those are the 50 people that need to hear from you again. So make sure that you're keeping an eye on the tracking that BombBomb provides, because these are people saying, I want more. I want to hear more from you. Now you can follow up by either segmenting or exporting your list based on the interactions that they have and follow up with an email, or you can call them. There's no 100% way to do this, but either way, the people that are showing you interest are the people that need to hear from you again. Now, the best part about this as well is that our tracking is going to show you when you should be following up with them. If somebody's opening their email and watching your video right now, that's somebody that needs to be followed up with. You don't want to be reaching out to your clients when they're in a business meeting. You don't want to be bugging them when they're fixing dinner for their kids or ordering pizza. You want to be reaching out to them in the best opportunity for you to actually touch base. Well, if you see them open and watch your video right now, now is the time to call. Now is the time to reach out again, because this is a window of opportunity where they're engaged with the content that you have sent. Now, rule number two, make sure that people are seeing the value that you are offering. Here's an example for you. What if I sent you a 45-second video and I had the value and the call to action about 30 seconds into that video? Well, one of the tracking features that BombBomb provides is what percentage of the video did the recipient watch? Well, what if they only watched 25% of my video? They didn't even get to the value. They didn't even get to the call to action and what I wanted to receive back from them. That's not going to be a successful video. So yes, they watched it, but they didn't get to the most important parts. Now, in last month's video, or a couple of months ago's video, Darren Dawson, our president, was talking about call to actions. And he talked about bookending your video with a call to action, putting it at the beginning and putting it at the end. That's a great way to make sure that they won't miss it, regardless of how much they watch. But I want you to use that percentage of video watched as a tool to let you know how long of my videos are people wanting to watch, and make sure that you are fitting the value, that you are fitting the call to actions in that time frame. It's a great way to make sure that we're not bothering our clients with 10-minute long videos, but we're giving them what they need to hear in 60 seconds. The third rule that I want to go over with you guys here today is save yourself time. How many times have you sent somebody information in an email and you're sitting there kind of twiddling your thumbs going, I haven't heard back from them. Have they engaged? Have they gotten the information? This is really time sensitive. I need to know that they've gotten it, right? How many times have you sent a listing or a contract or a document or a website that they needed to visit or a calendar link to your calendar to schedule some time to talk, and you don't know what they're doing? Now you do. Because we track those link clicks, like I mentioned before, now you're gonna see that they actually clicked on that link in your email, that they're engaging with the content. Now, of course, you still wanna hear back, but now you don't need to call them 5 times to check in. You don't need to send them a couple of texts to say, hey, did you get that information I sent you? No, you can check that off your list, know that they got the information that they needed, and make that assumption that they are working through exactly what you need to work them through. Now, of course, if you don't hear back for a couple of days, follow up exactly like we talked about in point number one. But at least now you can take a little bit of that stress off and save yourself time by not calling somebody 5-6 times in the day to make sure they got the information. Our tracking is going to provide that for you. So the three top ways that you can start using the BombBomb tracking are by following up with people that engage at the right time to engage with them, by making sure that people are seeing the value in the videos that you're sending, and also by saving yourself time. These are all different ways that you can work smarter and harder by using the BombBomb tracking to make sure that you're being the best and the most effective you can be in your business.